So we have spent too much time on the discussion of buddy group. So let's begin the discussion of question answers. So here first question is that where was Abdul Kalam's house? So who is going to tell me this answer? Where was Abdul Kalam's house? Yes. Aparan.
Abdul Kalam's house was on Mosque Street in Rameshwaram.
You can also tell about some lines on house. How kind, what kind of house was that? Pakka or kacha?
It was a type of pakka house, and the family in which he lived was the Tamil family.
Okay. And this house was made up of?
Limestone.
Limestone and? Bricks.
Bricks.
Yes, it is given in your chapter. So Vanshika is having no mic. So strange. Vanshika, where is your mic? You have not. What happened today? Today there are very less participants. They are still in computer class. They are still in computer class. Okay, so Abdul Kalam's house was basically a pakka house. It was made of brick stones, limestone, and this house was situated in Mosque Street in Rameswaram. Now let's move to next question. What do you think Chintamani is name of? Give a reason for your answer. Chintamani. Because when I explained this chapter, I didn't tell you the meaning of Chintamani. What is that? Okay, Dhiren, you tell me. Okay, Ridhima, you tell me.
Ma'am, I think Chintamani is a newspaper.
Very good. It is a name of a newspaper.
Newspaper.
Ma'am, newspaper.
And Abdul traces their the Second World War news in the headlines.
Yes, because it was a time when Second World War was going on, and Abdul Kalam, he used to read headlines to know about World War, and he was the fact that he assisted his cousin in collecting newspaper bundles, and it was thrown from the train. All these incidents indicate that Chintamani was the name of a daily newspaper. You can write down all the incidents which were associated with that name. So from that, it is crystal clear that it was a name of a newspaper. Okay. So same answer I expect from Nitya. Nitya, you tell me same answer.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, bachche.
The first one, ma'am, or the second one?
Which one is going in the class? Where is Chintamani written?
Ma'am, the first one I have written right now.
But I am discussing about Chintamani. Second.
Can I answer the first one?
Okay, you answer first one.
Abdul Kalam was born in an island town of Rameswaram in Madras state. His father, General Abdin, didn't have education or money. He was born in a middle class family. His house was really small, and
the question is, where was his house situated? You have to tell the location of his house. You have to tell the location of his house.
in the island, the Pamban island of Rameswaram in Madras?
It was in the most street in Rameswaram. And you have to tell about that this house was made of limestone or bricks. You have to mention these lines also in your answer. Okay? But I was discussing second answer. So, second answer I expect from Ekjot Kaur.
Yes, ma'am. It is a well-known Tamil newspaper.
If this answer is asked for 2 or 3 marks, so you will be writing only one line. Tell me. You will be writing only one line.
No, ma'am.
So explain which lines are associated with. You can explain that incident, that what duty he was doing with his cousin. He was throwing newspaper from train. Isn't it? He was throwing newspaper from train.
Yes, ma'am.
You can tell about this thing.
He helped his cousin in the distribution of newspapers in Rameswaram and earned his first wages. And it is a well-known Tamil newspaper.
Yes. Okay. Now next question is, Renuka, you will take, you just take a screenshot of these 25 participants. You also take and I will also be taking. Because these 24, 25 will be marked present today. Okay, so you have to tell that Abdul Kalam, he used to read headlines to know about World War II and the fact that he assisted his cousin and the episode or incident that is told about how they collect newspaper bundles and how did they threw away from the moving train. So all these indicate that Dinamani was the name of a daily newspaper. Now third question. Who were Abdul Kalam's school friends? What did they later become? Now tell me. This answer from where you can get it? Yes, fourth paragraph. In fourth paragraph, name of friends are given. And their career is also given in this paragraph. Then what did they become in their life? By reading, underlining the lines of fourth paragraph, you can come to know because some difficult names are given. So you can pick up these names from fourth paragraph. So who is going to tell me? Hariyak? Shivansh, Jasleen, Parmeet, who is ready with this answer? Hurry up. Raise your hand. Parmeet is ready, Shivansh is ready, or Jasleen is ready? Let me find out intelligent. Who is the most intelligent? Parmeet, Jasleen, or Shivansh? Whose answer is ready? Parmeet, Shivansh, and Jasleen. Three are not able to give me the answer. Parmeet, keep your video on. If you don't want to keep it on, no problem. Tell me your answer. Parmeet, Shivansh, or Jasleen. Otherwise, I will mark you absent today. Renuka, where will you send me attendance? The just mark them absent. Parmeet, Shivansh, they are not responding in class. It means they are not present. They have kept their laptops and mobiles on, but they are not present in front of the class. So they should be marked absent today.
Good morning, ma'am.
Ma'am, due to network problem, my class was connecting. So please tell me what is the question number you are asking.
Who spoke this?
Ma'am, I am Jasleen.
Jasleen, okay. Jasleen, third question is going on. You tell me this.
Jasleen. Okay, ma'am.
Okay.
Abdul Kalam's friend were Ramananda Sreshti. And one of his friend became a priest in Raveshram. Another friend, Arvedanam, went into the business of arranging transport for visiting the pilgrims. And third of his friend became a catering contractor for Southern Railway.
Very good. What's Southern? Southern Railways. Okay, good. Jasleen should be marked present. What about others too? Okay, Daljeet, you tell me same answer.
Yes, ma'am. Abdul Kalam was having three friends, Ramananda Shastri, Aravindan, and Sivaprakasan. All his friends were from Orthodox Hindu Brahmin families. Ramananda Shastri was the son of high priest of Rameswaram temple. Later he took over the priesthood of the Rameswaram temple from his father. Aravindan went into the business of arranging transport for visiting pilgrims. Sivaprakasan became a catering contractor for the Southern Railways.
Okay, good. Now let's move to next question. How did Abdul Kalam earn his first wages? Very simple answer. How did he earn his first wages? You have to tell about the incident of collecting tamarind seeds and throwing a newspaper. How did Abdul Kalam earn his first wages? Hurry up. Parmeet is ready with the answer or not? Parmeet, you are being marked absent. So why don't you try to give the answer? Only then you'll be marked present by me. Parmeet is present or not? Parmeet, show me your face. Parmeet, show me your face.
Good morning. You're
present or not? हाँ तो रिस्पांस भी नहीं कर रहे हाँ तो टेल मी आंसर
मैम फोर्थ क्वेश्चन
हाँ फोर्थ क्वेश्चन वेयर वर यू व्हेन आई अनाउंस्ड योर नेम अर्लियर टेल मी दिस आंसर
अब्दुल कलाम अर्नड हिज फर्स्ट वेजेस बाय कैचिंग बंडल्स ऑफ द न्यूज़पेपर्स थ्रू आउट फ्रॉम द मूविंग ट्रेन ऑन द रामेश्वरम रोड बिटवीन रामेश्वरम एंड धनुषकोडी एंड डिस्ट्रीब्यूटिंग देम
Only this much. Elaborate with some more content. This answer should be elaborated. Okay, Ridhika. Ridhika, you tell me this answer. Ridhika. Okay, Riddhi Kapoor. Riddhi Kapoor. Riddhi Kapoor. They are not responding now. They should be marks absent. Mitansh.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, bachche. Tell me fourth answer.
Yes, ma'am. Abdul Kalam earned his first wages by catching handles of newspapers from moving trains for his cousin Shamsuddin, who used to distribute newspapers in Rameswaram, Rameshwaram during the Second World War, the train halt at Rameshwaram station was suspended, so bundles of newspapers were thrown off moving trains and had to be collected.
Okay, good. Well tried. Pranay, you tell me this answer.
Abdul Kalam earns his first wages during the Second World War when the stoppage of trains was cancelled at Rameshwaram. The newspapers were bundled and thrown out of the moving train. Kalam's cousin, who was distributing the newspapers, asked him to help him to collect the bundles.
Okay, Laksh Jarath, you tell me this answer.
Yes, ma'am. At the age of eight, when the First World War broke out, for certain some reasons, the demand for tamarind seeds erupted in the market. He used to collect the seed and sell them to a provision shop on the mosque street. So, and also he cached newspapers from moving trains and distributed them at various places with the help of his cousin. And selling seeds, he earned his first wages successfully.
The first incident that you have told about that tamarind seeds, they were in demand. It was okay. But second incident was not elaborated properly, because you were saying that he was giving newspaper in moving train. You have to write down that he helped his cousin in collecting newspaper bundles, which were thrown away from the moving train. Okay?
Okay, ma'am. I was not clear about this line.
Yes. So you have to write down like that, which were thrown away from the moving train. So this task helped Abdul Kalam to earn his first wages.
Wages.
Now, had he earned any money before that? In what way? You can tell about that tamarind seeds episode, that there was a huge demand of tamarind seeds. So Abdul Kalam used to collect tamarind seeds and sell the day's collection to a provisions shop for one anna every day. Clear? For one anna every day. Now, next question is a long answer. How does the author describe his father, his mother, himself? So first of all, tell me, how did he describe his father? What personality traits are talked about his father? So let's count the personality traits of his father and start writing. Personality traits. Traits, you can say qualities of his father. So I'm providing you hints. With the help of these hints, you can frame good answer. Okay. Now tell me, what traits come in your mind? What personality traits comes in your mind? Type in chat box. What do you think? Generous, honest, simple, strict. Okay. So let me type. He was generous, kind, honest, strict. Okay. Then, yes, very good. Very good. So many students are now writing. Now they have got up. After listening my sound, now they have got up. I will listen to my scolding. Religious. Yes, very good. Religious. Yes. Man of true spirit. Yes. Discipline loving. Generous, kind, honest, strict, religious, man of true spirit. discipline, loving. Yes. Generous, kind, honest, strict, religious, man of true spirit, discipline, loving, and yes, avoid inessential comforts and luxuries. So these all are the personality traits of his father. You can write down. Mother. Now let's think about mother. What kind of lady she was? Yes, very good. Type in chat box. Generous, kind, used to feed everyone. Yes, used to feed everyone, visiting the house. Yes, which personality traits come in your mind? Yes, very good. Helper. Towards community. Yes. Embodiment of kindness and gentleness. Yes. True spirit of love, compassion. Yes. Yes, very good. All attributes of a typical mother. Used to tell stories. From epics. So from that we can tell that she was religious. So with the help of these points, you can write down this question that these were the traits of father, these were the traits of mother, and how does he describe himself? How does he describe himself? What personality traits he tells about him? Short. Yes, short. Thin, yes, short, thin boy, yes, descended from tall and handsome parents. These were the personality traits of him. Okay. So with the help of these points, you can frame a very good answer. I provided you so many words, and these words I have not typed on my own. I have read from your chat box. Yes. Whatever you are typing in chat box, I have only taken from there. It means you have so many ideas. So why don't you speak in class these ideas? So who is going to tell me this answer? How does the author describe his father, his mother, himself? So raise your hand, get ready with this answer. Who will be telling me this answer? Okay, Simran. After Simran, Riti Kapoor should be ready.
Yes, ma'am. Everyone has different personalities, and so did the family of APJ Abdul Kalam. The author describes his father as honest and self-disciplined. His father used to avoid inessential comforts and luxuries. The author tells that his father never had a formal education or much wealth, but he possessed great wisdom and was very generous. He was strict and religious. He was the man of true spirit in the eyes of everyone.
But
he loved his father from his heart due to his kindness. Author describes his mother as the ideal helpmate to his father. She used to feed a lot of outsiders along with her family members. She was very generous and kind and helped everyone. She was the true spirit of love and compassion. She used to tell stories from epics and was a religious person. The author describes himself as a thin, short boy who was born to tall and handsome parents. He said he had undistinguished looks but inherited many good things like love and kindness from his parents.
And how did he describe himself?
He described himself as a thin, short boy, born to tall and handsome parents. He said he thought that he had undistinguished looks, but instead he had inherited many good things from his parents, like love and kindness.
Very perfect. I'm really happy with your performance. Your answer was perfect. You have collected all those ideas, all those hints which I have provided. You have written on your own also. So good. Keep it up. Now, Riti Kapoor.
Yes, ma'am. The author described his father that he was a kind and honest person. He was strict, but the man of true spirit. He was a discipline loving person, and also tells he avoid essential comfort and luxurious life, and he was generous to others. The author described his mother as he was generous and helped toward his father, and also used to feed everyone who visited their house, and he was also the true spirit of love towards other. His mother was typical Indian mother and used to tell stories from epics, and this tells she was religious. And the author tells himself as he was short and thin boy, which